What's up, guys? I'm Reckless, and welcome to Guardian Watcher. So, Destiny 2 has been out for a little over 2 months now, and the Curse of Osiris, or Taku, is right around the corner. I've had more than enough time to test each and every subclass for each class, which consists of the Warlock, Hunter, and Titan, in and out of PvE as well as PvP. Today, I want to go over with you guys what I feel is the best Voidwalker class setup. Now, before all of you go crazy, freak out, and try to jump down my throat, no homo, this is my 100% opinion from which I'm entitled to, and you may agree or disagree. Either way, this setup has got me through Crucible and the raid with ease. I'm going to be going over the subclass itself, the armor stats that you should aim for, and the different exotic pieces of armor that I use in different parts of the game. I will not go over the weapons because I previously did a separate video on that subject, and I will put a link to that in the description below if you guys would like to check that out. Now, let's start with the subclass. For my grenade, I like using Axiom Bolt, which a bolt of void light that forks into smaller bolts on impact that seek out enemies. As for my class ability, I like using Healing Rift, and it goes along with the build pretty well. And you obviously can't get rid of Nova Bomb, which you hurl an explosive bolt of void light at the enemy, disintegrating those caught within its blast. And as for my jump, I love using Blink, no matter what. I do. Blink has just been amazing. However, all of this in combined with Attunement of Hunger, it is amazing. Now, I used to try to use Attunement of Chaos, but it doesn't work as good as Attunement of Hunger does. So, as for Attunement of Hunger, we have the Devourer perk, which strike an enemy with this melee ability to fully regenerate your health. For a short time afterward, kills restored additional health. Next perk we have is Feed the Void, which consume your grenade energy to regenerate your health, grants the Devourer effect, which is this. Next, we have Insatiable, which, while the Devourer effect is active, killing enemies extend its duration and recharges your grenade. All three of these, in conjunction with each other, just make this build beautiful. Next, we have Vortex, which Nova Bomb creates a singularity which continually damages enemies trapped inside. I personally think that the Attunement of Hunger is the best out of both the Attunement of Hunger and the Attunement of Chaos. I would use this no matter what in PvE and PvP, and yeah, I probably wouldn't never ever use Attunement of Chaos. And the whole thing is Cataclysm takes too long. It really does. In order to effectively get the effect off of Cataclysm, you need to make sure your opponents are not paying attention, or you come around a corner extremely fast. Other than that, Vortex works perfectly fine. Now, I use this exact subclass for everything in the game for both PvE and PvP. I don't see any reason to switch the subclass around except when running the raid, from which I will change my grenade to Vortex Grenade, as well as my jump to Burst Glide. Or, if I'm playing Control in the Crucible, then I'll just switch to Vortex Grenade and keep Blink. So, let me explain how to properly use a Devourer perk. Do not, and I repeat, do not waste the effect of the Devourer perk by starting it off with your melee. Always consume your grenade to start the combo off. Meleeing an enemy should be a last-minute resort if you can get an easy kill when you have to reload. Don't waste the effect if you don't have to. Next, we are going to skip over the stats for a moment and go straight into the exotic piece of armor that I use. I primarily use two different pieces of armor. My main armor that I use is the Karnstein armlets, from which you need to get yourself a pair because Xur is selling them this week. The intrinsic perk reads, Vampire's Caress. Melee attacks grant health recovery and melee grenade and class ability energy. And the second piece of exotic armor that I use is the Nezarek Sin, which its intrinsic perk reads, Abyssal Extractors, which void damage kills increase ability energy recharge rate. Due to the wording of Nezarek Sin, you don't have to be a Voidwalker to get this effect off. All you need are weapons that do void damage and it'll still work. Both of these exotics are definitely top picks, and they are universal exotics, which means you can use them on any Warlock subclass and get their effects off. Now, lastly, let's talk about armor stats. You want to aim for 1 mobility, 4 resilience, and 10 recovery. Now, I'm not sure if any other class like the Hunter or Titan can get this type of setup, but as a Warlock, the current meta, you primarily want to have at least 4 points in resilience and as much recovery as possible, and the reason for this is because of the infamous MIDA multi-tool. I actually go more in depth with this in the MIDA review that I did, and I will also put that in the description below. Personally, when it comes to the Voidwalker, I would recommend that Bungie do a few changes. And those would be that the Axiom Bolt and the Attunement of Hunger's Nova Bomb travel a little bit faster, because there have been a few times where somebody outran my Axiom Bolt by like a mile, as well as some people were able to react to my super while I was activating it without being able to get killed. I don't know, after both of those, I felt like it was kind of a waste of resources when using my abilities. But topics like those will be specifically in other videos like my What Needs to Change series. And that, fellow Guardians, brings us to the end. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, share it, and if you have any ideas for a future video, let me know in the comments below. Feedback is always appreciated. Subscribe and turn on notifications for more Destiny content. Thank you guys for all of your support. And remember, less guns doesn't mean less crime. And I will see you guys next time.